Hi, this is Rich, WB5YBZ. I'm in Oklahoma City, and I thought, what would be fun if I could use my gutters as an antenna? Now, I have a full wave, I made a full wave loop with my gutters and it worked great one time. But I thought just as it branches off one side and ran over to the other side, might just see how it would do. So let's go on over to the computer and let me show you what I've done and where we go from here. Thanks so much for watching. All right, this is my house from a bird's eye view, you might say, thanks for Google Maps. This is a chimney right in here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to hook up on this side of the gutter a wire coming down about 12 feet down to the ground where my balun will be. I have a 9-to-1 balun. So this is 20 feet and this is 18 feet. And then the wire would make it another 12. So what's that, 50 feet? Yeah, 50 feet. Of wire going this way, and this is 42 feet and 20 feet, and that's 62 feet plus another 12 feet for the wire going down the balun. It would make it another 74 feet altogether. What I did is the main antenna part I hooked to this. I tried it on this, and then I just it just wasn't working right. So I flipped the switch, the wires. And that's what I did. My balun, I'm using a balun from myantennas.com, a 9-to-1 balun. Here's the part number for it. It's a high-powered balun. I'm only using 100 watts on this one. What I did is this area right in here that goes on the shorter length, I put it this area right up here. And this says ground here, but you can also hook to what they call a counterpose. And I used this on this area right in here, not a ground, but it seemed like it worked pretty good, except on 80 meters. I had to hide a SWR on 80 meters. So let's go on over there. I want to show you what the MFJ antenna analyzer, and let me just show you the readings I got on that. It's sort of surprising on some of those. So let's go on over there now. All right, 80 meters, about 400, it's 8.6 to 1. And if we go down to 3.5, it shoots up about 9.0. So let's see, halfway between 7, 9.4. 40 meters, about 300, it's about 3.6, and now if we go to 7.0, it's 2.5. 30 meters at 10.100 megahertz is 4.7, and then if we move it up to 10.150, it's also 4.7. 20 meters down the pretty close to 1400 is 3.7. And about 350, it's really on 340, it's 3.7 as well. 17 meters, which is really good, 1.3 SWR. And let's see, it goes up to 168. Having a hard time here. We'll call that good. It's probably a little bit more at 1.3. Now this is really amazing. 17 meters would be really good. At 15 meters, also good at 1.3. and we're going to shoot it up to 450. It's also about 1.3. Real good SWR there on 15. This is close to the band on 12 meters. It's about 28.886. It starts at 890, and it's 1.6. And if we go up to 990, 24.990, no, I just can't quite get there. 28, 24, 8, 8. There we go, 1.6, which is really, really good. Well, let's go up to 10 meters or 28 megahertz and just see how it does. Say at 28, pretty close there. Let's go 28.4, which is the calling frequency. 3.2 SWR. Let's go up to 28.6 just for the fun of it. 3.3, and let's go to the FM portion. FM is 29,600. And it's 3.7, which is not bad all across the 10 meter band. Let's go on up to 6 meters, 50 megahertz. And of course, the antenna tuner on this one for sure. I could try to get down in the CW portion a little bit, maybe a little bit more. 4.6 and 5125. I just barely wiggle this and it goes all over the place. I'm going to call it there. 4.7. And let's go up to 52 and see what it is. 52, and there used to be a calling frequency around 2.5 or something. It's 4.2 megahertz. So let's go on up to 54 and 4 megahertz, 4 SWR. Okay, I have a 9-to-1 Balun down there. It's going up here to, I guess, the hot wire, so to speak. I believe it could be the hot wire, up to that gutter. It goes around to the corner here, and of course we have a gutter going down. And let me show you what we have. We have a gutter going over here to this edge, and it just sort of stops right there. It's a drop off to another gutter. So that's our main hot gutter. Over here is the poise, there we go. And it's hooked up here as well. And of course we have a downspout here. And it goes way over there. This is a little longer, but for some reason, when I change the wires and use the other one for the center lead, I believe it's the center lead. Anyway, it worked. The antenna tuned a lot better. What I do is I just put a paper clip on this support right here. Like that. It's real close to my chimney here. And I put the other one up here. I have YBZ.
Hey Rich, yeah, you were like you were next door, and now I can barely hear you. I think you are in, but so I'm in Tucson, Arizona, Alpha Zulu QSL. Copy that. You gotta use what you got. That makes sense. So I'm on an Nikon 7100 with just a
Five
foot pole here. The cheapest antenna I have, and it seems to work the best. Back to you.
Roger, Roger. Well, it sounded good. You get hit a 5.8 that time, and so it sounded good, and your ICOM sounded good. Good audio, good quality audio. Are you using the stock mic or headset or what there? Over. Roger, Roger. What do you do over there in Arizona? Over.
I'm in the Air Force. Been in 28 years, wrapping up about a 30-year career out here.
Roger, Roger. Well, super duper. Well, yeah, thank you for your...
So, we got here. Wonder what you're running. Hold on. I got to get going with the bad weather we've got coming up. W5YB question mark W0 Echo Radio Echo.
Okay, W7 Echo Radio Echo Whiskey Baker 5 Yankee Baker Zulu Whiskey Bravo 5 Yankee Bravo Zanzibar. We're in Oklahoma City and we're running a gutter here, using a gutter for an antenna. It's 10 feet off the ground and we're using an ICOM 7300. I just thought I'd try the gutter antenna, see how it would do. But you're sounding good here. You're 5'9" plus probably about 5 over S9. The name is Rich, not poor, but Rich, and I appreciate you coming back to me. W7EREWB5YBZ.
Yeah, I think it's Whiskey Baker 5, Yankee Baker Zulu, YBZ, I think. Okay, Rich. Rich, which direction are you? I'm located in
Nebraska.
Where are you located, over?
We're in Oklahoma City. Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Over.
Oh, status level is horrible. Did you say Oklahoma City? Is that correct, over?
Roger, Roger. Over.
Okay, all right. Are you able to hear me okay? Go ahead.
You're very strong, over.
Okay, I'm trying to check conditions, see what we're dealing with here. Of course, you're 90 degrees off, and the curtain is pointed north-south, southeast-northwest. It's sure not on you, buddy. I'm surprised you're hearing me. Just think what the band is like. Let me hear this. Again, my name is Al, Alpha Lima, A-L, near Branson. I'm going to shut the amplifier off. Watch your S-meter. This is with the amplifier. This is 1,000 watts. 1,000 watts. Hello, radio. I'm going to shut it down just to the driver and let me know what you see for difference. Here we go. There is 100 watts. Just to the driver, Yaesu 920. Yaesu FB 920. Hello, radio. 100 watts. 100 watts. There's back to a KW. What can you tell me about the increase or decrease? Over.
You're 10 over S9 with an amplifier and a S8. An S8 without the amplifier, but you're 10 over S9 with the amplifier. Over.
Okay, well, that's amazingly well, because the antenna is sure not on you, buddy. It isn't on you. Okay, at S8, with a static level like it is, are you able to hear me without the amp at this time? Over.
Roger, Roger.
That's amazing. And you're using a rain gutter for an antenna, is that right?
Just using my gutter, yes, sir.
Bless you, buddy. Bless you, God. My kind of man. Yeah, I've loaded everything from sunflowers to barbed wire fences to D9 bulldozers and every antenna in between. The antenna I'm using right now is a commercial broadcast. It's a Sturba, S-T-E-R-B-A, Sturba curtain antenna, made out of number 10 copper weld wire. If you look on the internet, you'll see it. I sure appreciate your help, Rich. Is the weather getting bad where you are yet? How is your weather, over?
Well, right now, Al, it's at the top of Oklahoma, right at the top of Oklahoma, but it's supposed to be, I think, coming down a little bit later on tonight, but right now it's at the very north part of Oklahoma, but you're coming in 10 over, sometimes 20 over S9, Al, over.
God, that's amazing. Yeah, you're up to S9, up to S985 dB over, which is incredible because my antenna's not on you. And you're using a rain gutter. You're my kind of man, buddy. I'm an experimenter. That's 90% of what I do is experiment. Well, tell me this. Are you using 75 or 50 ohm coax, or how are you feeding that? I presume that you have a tuner, over.
Oh, Roger, Roger. I have a LDG tuner. And I'm using RG8 coax, just RG8 coax going up to my gutter, probably about 50 feet of coax on there, Al, before it gets to the gutter. And most most of the coax is just in a circle on the yard there. But one side of the gutter is about, including wire. I have wire going down to my Balun, and one gutter is probably about 50 feet long, and with the wire, and the other one's about 70 feet long. But for some reason, the center lead of the 50 foot long tunes up easier than the 70 foot long. So I don't know about that, but it just seems like it does a little bit better job on tuning. But anyway, it's just been fun to be able to get on here and talk. Normally I have an 80 meter full wave loop for 80 meters, 80 meter full wave loop that's up about 35 feet, but I thought, well, I'm just going to try this gutter and just see how it does. But I can't believe I'm hitting a S9 up there by Branson. Over.
Yeah, you beat it almost. Hello. Hello, radio. Okay. Confirming I'm in operation here. You actually peaked almost 10 dB over. Almost 10 dB over over a 9 that time. Unbelievable. So, wait a minute. Are you actually loading the gutter, or do you have wire laying in the gutter with a dipole? How are you feeding it? I mean, I know you got RG58, but do you have the gutter cut in half? Do you have two different lengths over?
Well, I'm using RG8, and I have just a regular, probably a 18-gauge wire that's going up to a paper clip. I have a paper clip that hooks onto the support of the gutter, and I just slide it on there. And then on the other side, I have one gutter going one side of the chimney and one gutter going on the other side of the chimney. Both of them make an L shape. And on the other gutter, on the other side of the chimney, I have a paper clip going to the wire and dropping down to the Balun. So it's just paper clipped on. It's just sort of a temporary situation there, Al. Over.
I love it. 75YBZ, W0 Echo Radio Echo. Well, if you look on QRZ, do you have a computer in front of you by any chance? Over.
Wasn't that fun? I tell you what, it does make a difference of your length of your gutter. If it's very far off from a given frequency, as you know, mathematical frequencies are mathematical formulas for certain bands. If it's really off, you might not be able to tune a gutter, but it's just fun to try to see what you can find. If some of the houses have better gutters in the back, and they're sort of V-shape. I'm holding the camera hard to make a V. And the backyard, or the back of the roof, has just gutters on one side, and on the front it has gutters on the one side. And you might, just for the fun of it, take a wire going to your front gutter, tying it to a Balun, maybe even try a one-to-one Balun. And then also the other wire going to your backyard gutter. And you cut the wire down, lengthen it and shorten it, and it might be better on the frequency. Sometimes it won't work at all, but it's just fun to try it. Now, I did make a video a couple years ago or more of, I made a full wave loop with a 2.5 to 1 Balun from Balun Designs, and that worked really, really good, as made a full wave loop out of my guttering system. And that was a lot of fun. So with that, I won't bore you anymore, but sure, thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, 73. I'm just gonna try this gutter and just see how it does, but I can't believe I'm hitting a S9 up there by Branson. Over.
Yeah, you beat it almost. You actually peaked almost 10 dB over. Almost 10 dB over a 9 that time. Unbelievable.